In this video, me and Jake continue on a series of videos looking at steel conduit. We've gone through the conduit bending machine, boxes, fixings, threading, and in the last video, we put a bend in to an exact measurement from the back of the bend to the end of the conduit at 300 mil. But I left you with a challenge. And what was that challenge?
That's right, Gary, you give me a challenge of bending a length over a meter. You said you think it's going to hit the floor. I'm going to show you how to overcome that problem. So last time we bent a piece of conduit at 300 millimetres from the back of the bend. This time we're going to do it at a metre. So I'm going to mark this piece now.
So from the end of the conduit to the back of the bend will be 1 metre. Previous video we said it was obviously 300. Check out the video if you haven't already seen it. And we bent that conduit down. And obviously we know with this sort of length, we're not going to be able to do that. So there's your 1 metre mark. And I'll just have a look at that. So from here to the end of your conduit, you've got that at 1 metre. And I know that's going to clash with the floor when you bend it. So how are you going to overcome that?
Yep. Well, Gary, last time we inserted the conduit underneath the handle under the stop this way.
Yes.
We're going to do it the reverse. So we're going to have the handle down.
Ah, so you're bending it upwards.
Yep. We're going to put this stop down. I'm going to bend up to the ceiling.
So you're still sending in the correct measurement of conduit. So this is your 1 metre length going in.
That's right.
Is it the same technique to work out the back of the bend?
It is, yep. So I'm going to use scrap piece of conduit. Again, in the former.
What we did before, yeah. And our set square, yes?
That's right.
Right. So this should be, this mark here that you bring in, according to where the conduit sits on the former, and that mark on the set square, that should be the 1 metre to the back of the bend.
So 90 degrees there.
You've got the two at 90 degrees, yeah.
And that line is between the set square and the scrap conduit.
Okay, the only problem now is when you take your hands off, that other thing, that conduit's going to fall and move.
Yep, so I need to keep the pressure on there.
Ah, right, okay, there's a mistake waiting to happen, is it? So you put the pressure onto the conduit, holding that position before you pull up the arm. I see your foot's back on the machine again.
Yep.
And you're going to bend that one up. So that should be from the back of the conduit bend to the end of the conduit. You said that was going to be 1 metre. And if we tried to bend it the other way around, this piece here would have hit the floor, wouldn't it?
That's right.
So you're going to try and set that to 90.
Yep, so I'll step back, take a look at that. That looks somewhere really close, so I'll take that out and have a look.
Well, moment of truth. Again, it doesn't matter which way around we put it now. Does it square is square? So obviously this is the shorter length coming towards me. And what you think is the 1 metre going the other way.
So we'll get our set square.
So you're going to put that against the surface, against the wall, and then the conduit. Are we square?
Slightly overbent there.
Oh, overbent this time. So
yeah, I don't know my own strength, Gary.
Take your arm out of the way for us. Let's have a closer look. So we've... So last time you underbent it, and I said you don't want to overbend it because it's more tricky to obviously adjust it. Unfortunately, Jake, you're going to have to adjust it for me.
It's only a slight amount, so it's not a problem. We can take that out. So when we've got a longer piece, one way to do it, foot on the conduit and just flex that slightly.
Ah, right, okay. Yeah, and that works with longer lengths, doesn't it? You just flex that out.
Yeah.
If I was going to do the conduit bending machine method, how would that work?
Yep, so we can lift the stop back up, insert it underneath, making sure the bend is as close as possible.
That's important, isn't it? So you've got the bent section there, really close to the end of the former, which could slip. What would happen if you pulled the conduit further back out then?
Yeah, so if we were to bend it all the way back here, right, we'd end up actually not pulling that bend out slightly, right, just creating another bend.
So top tip for me there, if you're doing it this way and you're going to try and pull the bend out there by flexing it, it's probably as you're training, maybe to get somebody this end to hold it, what you wouldn't want is that to slip and obviously it would end up face planting it, wouldn't you?
Yep. So we'll take this back over and have a look.
So against the
wall. Gone too far now.
Oh, so you've overdone
overshot
it.
That.
Okay, so you're gonna have to adjust it once more. So that's back to the original technique,
back to the
is
original,
it?
Yep.
So that's gonna be pulling it upwards, isn't it?
Yep, so stop, we'll have to go back down again.
So you can see as people are training or learning to work with conduit, it's actually understanding your own personal strength, isn't it?
That's right, definitely.
Yeah, so we slide it back in. And again, I wouldn't use the arm now. I like the what you're going to do now. You're just going to push that, aren't you? Because you think you've got a little bit more control?
Yeah, definitely. I don't. If I use the arm, I think, again, it's likely you'll put too much pressure on it. It's easily done.
So you're just going to... Yeah, just going to feel it go,
yeah? A slight amount, yeah.
Okay, yeah. So we've got, you know, several different techniques there. So when we offer it back up, we're hoping now we're back to 90 degrees, and then we can work out whether you've got your technique correct for the 1 meter. Well, spot on this time. Yeah. Yeah, look at the two running parallel with each other there. Well, that's not the end of it though, is it? You're going to have to spin it round.
Yeah, moment of truth, so we'll measure it up now.
So this is now from the back of the bend to the end of the conduit. It's got to be 1 meter. I don't know whether I'm pulling for you or not here. Here we go. So on the end here. So that's parallel with the surface. We're on to the end there. Oh, you're adjusting it. Yep. I'm going to pull back now. Moment of truth. So make sure that tape measure stays there. Don't want any jiggery pokery. So there we go, folks. So there we go. Let's look at the numbers. 70, 90...
So
need you to move your hand. Wow.
Just a couple of mil out there, Gary, but I can live with that.
Yeah, that's yeah. So you've done the same technique we did before for 300 mil to the back. Now we've done one meter, but we had to obviously flip that conduit bending machine around.
Yep. Well, Gary, you set me a challenge of bending a length of conduit over 1 meter. You thought it was going to hit the floor. I showed you how to overcome that. All we do when it's over 1 meter is reverse it.
Yeah, and at colleges, isn't it? A lot of the bends that students end up putting in conduit are well under 1 meter. Get on site and find all of a sudden that technique that was shown in the classroom doesn't work in practice. So thank you for showing that 1 meter technique. I always like to set you a challenge at the end of these videos now. So I've got in front of me here a piece of conduit with a double set in it. So in the next video, I'm going to challenge you, Jake, to put a double set to exactly 50 mil in a piece of steel conduit. If you haven't checked out the videos in this series, there'll be a link in the description. It might be in the eye above my head or certainly be in a playlist. And I recommend you go back over those ones. If there's anything you want to see Jake do in this series of videos, again, leave them in the comments and he'll get back to as many as he can.